Kuinka vanha te olette?
Ageless is the old of life.
Oletteko te naimisissa? Onko teillä lapsia?
No, I am a monk. I am a monk from the Himalayas.
Eikö se vaikeuta ihmisen todellisten ongelmien tuntemista, kun ei ole naimisissa?
I don't have to understand problems. I provide a solution to all problems. I don't have to understand the darkness. I bring in the light.
Pääiltaan. Tänä iltana vieraanamme on mies, joka sanoo, että transcendenttinen meditaatio, eli lähinnä mietiskelyn harjoittaminen, on keino, jolla pystytään ratkaisemaan muun muassa seuraavat ongelmat. Yksityistä ihmistä ajatellen, siis henkilökohtaisella tasolla, voitetaan stressi ja kärsimys. Valtiollisella tasolla sekä sisä- että ulkopoliittiset ongelmat. Kasvatuksen alueelta muun muassa sukupolvien välinen kuilu. Sosiaalisella tasolla mietiskelyllä voitetaan sekä perhe-elämän ongelmat että rikollisuus. Voitetaan ympäristöongelmat. Poistetaan köyhyys ja työttömyys sekä teollisuuden ja hallinnon ongelmat. Ja henkisellä tasolla tämä ajattelu täyttää nykyajan henkisen elämän sisällön puutteen. Siis tervetuloa Maharishi Mahesh Yogi. Onko teillä ollut kiireinen päivä tänään Helsingissä?
I've been very happy in this capital of Finland. It was a busy day, but my message has been received by important people in the town, and this brings satisfaction to me.
Ketä ihmisiä te olette täällä Helsingissä jo ehtinyt tavata?
Very important people in the field of education, in the field of health, other political people in the country, some businessmen, some students. All show interest in transcendental meditation.
Uskoisin, että meille suomalaisille Maharishi on lähinnä tuttu niiden valokuvien kautta, joita meillä muutama vuosi sitten oli hyvin paljon lehdistössä ajalta, jolloin Beatlesit mietiskelivät Maharishin kanssa. Näissä artikkeleissa kuitenkin puhuttiin enemmän Beatleseistä ja mietiskelystä kuin teistä Maharishi itsestänne. Sen vuoksi kysyisinkin, kuinka monta vuotta te olette ollut poissa Intiasta?
About 3 years. I came out because I was training teachers of science of creative intelligence, and the accommodation in my academy in Shankaracharya Nagar in India, accommodation is very small. And when I found that I could train 2,000 people in 3 months, then I thought, train them out of India. The whole purpose is to train as many people as teachers of transcendental meditation as possible. Doesn't matter where I train.
Kuinka monessa maassa te näiden vuosien varrella olette käynyt ja opettanut ihmisiä?
In about 60 countries by now.
Kuinka monessa televisiohaastattelussa te olette ehtinyt tänä aikana olla?
Must be over 1,000. It's about 15 years that I'm going around the world over again and again. And everywhere, some people are meditating, and the press has been very kind to the whole movement from the beginning. Because wise people in the press, they recognize the value of this practice, transcendental meditation. So they wish that it should be learned by all the people. So they have been very cooperative to spread the message.
Mitä te täällä Suomessa haluatte saada aikaan?
I want to give my message to the people that there is great intelligence deep in the mind of everyone, and it is not being used fully through the daily practice of transcendental meditation, 15 minutes morning, evening. It is possible for everyone to unfold the deeper values of his intelligence and become more creative, at the same time become more happy from inside. very stable emotions and very clear thinking. And when the man thinks clearly, then his actions are very right and they are progressive. This is what I want to inform all the people in Finland. This is a country very close to nature. Very close to nature. It has not been spoiled by international impacts of different ideologies. So there is some genuineness, some naturalness in the life of this country. And therefore, I want to inform the people of Finland that through the practice of transcendental meditation and through this knowledge of science of creative intelligence, it is possible for every man to live fully blossomed life.
Minkälaisiin tuloksiin tällä luovan ajatustoiminnan harjoittamisella päästään? Auttaako se ihmistä selvemmin näkemään vain omat ongelmansa? Vai auttaako se ihmistä näkemään myöskin paremmin ympärilleen toistekin ongelmat?
When perception becomes more refined and when intellect is more fully used, then not only one realizes the whole problem of society with reference to his life, but one is naturally capable of coming out of the problem situation. Not only the recognition of the problem, but naturally one finds a way out of problem.
Onko olemassa joku tietty piste, johon tällä ajatuksen kehityksellä pyritään? Mihin sillä pyritään?
It's a very beautiful question. In the answer, I'll explain the whole principle of transcendental meditation. What happens? Doctors tell us, and we know from our own experience, that our body is able to adapt to situations. We are here in this warm room. When we go out, it's very chilly outside. But the body doesn't collapse when we go out into the road, because it is capable of adjusting to the different situations. We are in a very peaceful atmosphere. If something happens like that and everybody begins to run away or something, the body is capable of responding to the requirement of the situation. And this we call adaptability. One is able to adapt to different situations. Now,
onko sopeuttaminen se pääasia, johon tällä menetelmällä pyritään, eikö se samalla merkitse tietynlaista alistumista?
Not submission, but proper evaluation of the situation and ability to derive maximum advantage from it. Not only evaluate the situation, but make it most beneficial to us. This range of adaptability increases through transcendental meditation. And then what happens? That whatever the situation, one is not exposed to stress or strain. If the adaptability is less, then one does not evaluate the situation properly and cannot derive maximum advantage from the situation. But if the mind and body are flexible, if they are capable of taking advantage of the situation, adapting to the situation, then one does not entertain stress or strain. This is the advantage from transcendental meditation.
Mitä käytännössä tämä mietiskely tarkoittaa? Millä tavalla sitä aivan noin konkreettisesti sanottuna harjoitetaan?
In learning meditation, one learns two things. One is, we call the mantra, the sound. Each person has to have a sound which suits him. And then a technique whereby one experiences finer state of that thought of the sound, the thought of the mantra. Experiencing the finer state of the thought, the mental activity becomes less and less and less. The mind settles down in a very restful state, but remains wide awake inside. This is the practice of transcendental meditation. The mental activity becomes less and less. One experiences fine state of the mantra till the mantra disappears and the mind remains in that wakeful state without a thought. basic personality of every person is full and complete. That can't be changed. Only the fullness is not being utilized. So that fullness begins to be used. So nothing changes in the person, only the unused abilities become lively and they begin to be used. So there is no question of change, it's only a question of making use of what is not being used.
Meditaatiosta kertovassa kirjassa sanotaan, että kiireisin tärkein asia maailmassa tällä hetkellä on kärsimyksen lopettaminen. Ja kun te sanotte, että meditoinnin avulla päästään eroon nälästä ja köyhyydestä, millä tavalla se tapahtuu? Onko kaikkien ihmisten alettava meditoida vai riittääkö esimerkiksi kun valtionpäämiehet mietiskelevät?
No, it's not only the head of state. It's the whole population whom he represents.
Mutta kuinka se on mahdollista?
Just by bringing this knowledge through radio and through television and through papers and by introducing it in educational system, every school, every college, every university should teach science of creative intelligence through every discipline.
Onko valtiomiesten, valtion päämiesten joukossa paljon mietiskelijöitä?
There are some, not many yet.
Mitä uskoisitte, millä tavalla mietiskely olisi vaikuttanut esimerkiksi Hitleriin?
Hitler would have been more useful for the whole world. His whole concentration was in Germany for Germans. But if he had been meditating, his awareness would have been broadened. And instead of making all the autobahns only within Germany, he would have made autobahns in Austria and all over.
Kuinka vanhat perinteet mietiskelyllä on Intiassa?
As old as mankind, we say. We don't know how old is the tradition of Vedas. Infinitely old, numberless.
Millä tavalla mietiskelyä harjoitetaan ja on harjoitettu Intiassa?
Like a tree coming out of the sap. The sap, colorless sap, formless sap, expresses itself in different forms, in different colors, green and yellow, like that, like that. Just like that, the same knowledge of life branches out in different expressions. All these different expressions of cultures, different branches of learning, they all come from that total value of knowledge of life.
Ketkä Intiassa harjoittavat ja ovat harjoittaneet mietiskelyä? Onko se älymystö vai onko se koko kansa?
Both kinds of people. Anyone who comes to know that transcendental meditation is such a simple thing, it only takes 15-20 minutes to show results. Just a matter of knowing it. Whosoever knows, he does it.
Millä tavalla mietiskely on sitten vaikuttanut Intian yhteiskunnallisiin oloihin? Mitä merkitystä sillä on?
As transcendental meditation will be practiced by the people more and more, social conditions, individual conditions, economic conditions, political conditions, and all these conditions will become better when people begin to meditate.
Mutta Intiassa sitä on harjoitettu jo satoja, kenties tuhansia vuosia. Miten se on vaikuttanut?
I think not transcendental meditation had been practiced in India. People got branched out in many systems of concentration and controlling the mind. They don't help the life to blossom in its full value. But now, this pure Vedic tradition to bring out this natural procedure of transcendental meditation it will improve the creative intelligence of the people, then every aspect of life will blossom in its full value. Hope is in this science of...
Te kuitenkin uskotte, että meillä suomalainen ihminen töistä kotiin tultuaan ja ennen television avaamista 15 minuuttia mietiskeltyään voi saada sen saman hyödyn kuin intialainen menettelemällä toisin ja aivan toisissa kulttuuriolosuhteissa.
Exactly. Because the inner of life is the same everywhere. Just like the inner part of the leaf, the inner part of the petal, the inner part of the stem, the inner part is the same sap everywhere. So the inner of life, intelligence, pure intelligence, is the same in all the people. Its expression in outer life differs.
Samaan aikaan kun te kierrätte maailmalla, nyt kiertää Guru Maharaji myöskin ympäri maailmaa keräämässä opetuslapsia. Mutta mistä me tiedämme, kenenkä perässä me lähdemme kulkemaan? Vai onko esimerkiksi teistä lopputulos sama, kuljemmeko me teidän perässänne vai hänen perässä?
I would say science of creative intelligence has proved its value through scientific experiments. So this seems to be the best. Because I am saying it for my own teaching, but I am satisfied with what I am teaching. Because it has proved through the years that it produces results which are verifiable through scientific methods.
Toisen suunnan edustaja Guru Maharaji, josta me äsken puhuimme, kerää parhaillaan lahjoituksia. Hän kerää itselleen miljoonaomaisuuksia. Oletteko te rikas mies?
I have no possessions, I have no pockets, I have no bank accounts.
Kenenkä varoilla te kierrätte maailmaa?
The organization. In every country there are organizations, there are teachers, and people pay to the teacher when they learn something, and the teacher barely gets money to keep his expenses paid in every country. People pay differently in different countries according to the standard of living in that country. I'm actually not aware what they pay in Finland, but it's something which everyone can pay like that. But because we don't make appeals for funds, people think that this is a very rich organization. But it's good to be known wealthy rather than to be known poor. But money is not either a problem or a goal. The goal is to see that no man suffers. Every man has this knowledge, so that every man is fully developed person. And now that we are appealing to the governments, and we are asking governments to employ the teachers of science of creative intelligence, pay them salaries as teachers of physics and chemistry and geography are being employed by the government, so teachers of science of creative intelligence should also be employed, and in the same style, this knowledge should reach all the people.
Kuinka paljon tämä mietiskely, koko sen harjoittaminen tällä hetkellä maailmassa, on teidän persoonanne varassa? Kaatuuko, elääkö se teidän persoonanne mukana tällä hetkellä?
Time is coming. It's not yet come. Time is coming when I would not be active in the field. And it will go on. This world plan will create that situation. When I have established 3600 teacher training center, one teacher training center for each million people in the world, I would have done my job. It doesn't depend on me. It is so much established that even if in my dream I happen to say, no, transcendental meditation doesn't work, people will not believe it.
Kuinka paljon te tarvitsette aikaa?
It is from just this month, from the month of October this year, that I have started to appeal to the governments. I think within 3-4 months I would have appealed to all the governments, all the departments. And once the governments take it up, it might take 1 or 2 years for the whole population to start meditation. It won't take long time. Just because the whole process is so simple, only it must reach many people, and that will be through the teachers. And to have that many teachers, we need the government support. And it will come, I'm quite sure, I'm very confident, just because every government is faced with many, many problems. And this promises relief from problems. And because the knowledge is so complete and the practice is so natural and simple that every man can do it, it won't take more than a year or two. Yes, this reminds me. This world plan was formulated in 72. So 72 was the year of the world plan. 73, this is the year of action for the world plan. 74, I count to be the year of achievement. I would have appealed to all governments and governments would have responded in that 1 year, 74. 75, I would count to be the year of fulfillment, and that will be it.
Onko vuosi 75 ensimmäinen onnellinen vuosi maailmassa näin?
That will be a foundation for happiness, for lasting happiness for the whole human race.